There's a threat in the world today. A threat to our way of living, a threat to our society, and maybe even a threat to our very existence. And what is this threat?
With that being said, let's wrap IndyCar up and get on to the Checkers and Wreckers picks of the week. So we're doing a little bit different this week, folks. We've been doing, you know, two NASCAR checkers and two NASCAR wreckers and then a dark horse. So this week with a opening day of IndyCar season, we're going to do one pick on each, one NASCAR pick and one IndyCar pick for checkers and wreckers, and we're going to do one pick each for dark horses too. So
yeah,
Tommy boy, lead them out. What are you looking like on your picks this week?
All right.
Do you want to do how do you want to do this? Do you want to do checkers and we'll give our IndyCar and NASCAR pick, or do you want to do NASCAR and then do IndyCar?
Let's just do checkers. We'll just do checkers. We'll keep it there.
All right.
So I guess for my checkers, who I think is gonna be top tier today, IndyCar. He's been on top speed wise. He's had the car. It seems like he is one of the guys to beat. He's not starting up front, but he's got some track position to make up. Ryan Hunter-Reay.
Yeah.
I think he's a good one. It seems that this weekend he's got the car dialed in. So if he can keep it going and nail it out, keep that momentum, I think he takes that.
That's a solid pick right there. Hunter-Reay, like we discussed earlier, has looked great in qualifying all weekend. He's had speed. He's been fast. So I could definitely see RHR getting up there and getting the win today.
Yeah, he's a veteran driver. So
yeah.
He knows what to do.
That's a solid pick.
NASCAR, I'm going with our buddy here. He's going to fly out here shortly, but Chase, I'm going to – gonna pick you to take that.
Thanks for hanging out with us today, Chase.
Yeah, really appreciate
it,
guys.
Alexander got to get back to the tracks and get in the cars and get ready, but we really appreciate you guys showing up for the show.
Yeah, can't thank you. I think they're going to be here next week, too.
Yeah.
So
that's going
to
be awesome.
I think contract obligations, they can't really talk too much. But
maybe we can get Chase to bring his helmet and put it out here, too, so we can add to the helmet collection.
Yeah. I think it'd be a good talk. So what do you got, I guess, going forward as far as checkers?
You know, I'm going to go with an IndyCar, the Iceman, Scott Dixon.
Okay.
0-14 at St. Pete.
Finally gets it.
I see him putting it in victory lane today.
Nice.
I see him getting it.
So I guess real quick with that pick, do you think he contends the title, and do you think he takes it again? Just a real quick blurb on that, I guess.
Too soon to tell.
Too soon to tell.
I mean, with it being Ganassi, being Scott Dixon, I say he's going to be a contender for the title. Does he repeat? It's too soon to tell.
He's done it 5 times, folks. He has never contended the title.
Back to back.
Never done it. So it'd be
his, let me see here. His first two were 5 years apart. And then I believe his first two was 5 years apart. And then I think everyone after that's been 3 years apart.
He's consistent. That's for sure.
Yeah.
So he's narrowing it down. So maybe this is the year he gets it. So I mean, he's pretty much hit every other tier or feat in his aspect. So he needs to throw it up and contend for it this year.
And then for NASCAR, I'm going with last week's winner, Joey Logano.
All right.
I mean, that it was kind of a toss up on that pick. I was definitely, I knew what team I was just gonna. Actually, I was gonna just. When you asked me what my pick was going to be, I was just going to say Team Penske.
So either Keselowski or Logano?
It's either Blaney, Logano, or Keselowski. I think one of them. But I'm going to go with Logano. And, you know, he's got momentum from last week. Like we discussed earlier, that Penske team's strong this year. The Fords are strong this year. So I see him competing for the win again today.
I think an interesting watch there will be the two teammates battling it out. Logano and Keselowski, I think we might see some tempers flare before
the end of the year. Don't forget about Blaney in there.
No, I know that, but I just see
he's their teammate too, and he's on the pole
after the first few races there with the last few races, Keselowski and Logano going after each other like that. Teammates, but
I think people made last week a lot worse than what it was. You know, they didn't really get into each other. I don't think there was any tempers flared up there. They just I'm trying to remember who was on the outside and who was on the inside. Was it the guy on the inside, Keselowski on the outside? I think one of them got a little bit loose coming through the turn, and that's just, so it was racing. That's what it was.
I always find it interesting when you got two teammates that are out there and they're the ones that are running for it every weekend.
Well,
it's fun.
But the bad part about that is, you know, with media and everything today, they always want to try, two teammates, and, you know, they're heated and they're mad at each other. I didn't see that even in the post-race interviews. You know, they both said, "Hey, it was just racing."
Absolutely. And yeah, that's I didn't mean it to sound like that at all, but I definitely think that come the end of the year, these two could be definitely putting it up and tossing back some knuckles for the wins here.
So, with that being said, what you got? What you looking like for records?
Records. I'm looking at IndyCar. Last year, he started on the pole. I don't know if he started. I think he did start on the pole last year, too.
This year, he's starting on the pole.
He is starting on the pole this year. I don't think he's going to end up taking it all the way. I think he ends up falling back in the pack, and I don't think Penske overall has a good running today.
Okay.
I'm sorry. And then NASCAR, my records would be hard. I don't necessarily think he's going to wreck, but I think he gets just caught up in some of that traffic and doesn't find his way to the front.
And that's funny because your brother, the ass, says Harvick's going to be the winner.
There you go.
He's saying Marco and Harvick are his wreckers.
Oh.
And checkers, I'm sorry. And Elliott and Hunter Ray are his wreckers.
So we pretty much flip that
one. Yeah, you're kind of flip-flopped on that one.
We'll see how that one works out there.
And then G Powell says Bush wins the NASCAR race with Kyle. I'm guessing you're saying Kyle Busch, right?
I would think so, yeah.
So for my records, let me bring it up here. I'm looking like IndyCar, surprise, surprise, surprise. Marco, he's going to stink it up today.
He's going to try to be hero first lap.
Oh, yeah.
You think he's going to be the guy?
He's going to be Pepe Le Pew today.
Pepe Le Pew. I like that.
he's going to stay.
Pepe Le Pew. I like that.
So
look out for that number 98, Pepe Le Pew.
Yeah. Like we discussed earlier, you know, your teammates are going out there and winning races and getting pole positions and running up front. And where's Marco at? It's not the team.
How's Damon? Boom, boom.
Yeah, it's not the team. You need to, you know, and I don't know Marco personally, so I'm not really trying to badmouth the guy, but I just – maybe, you know, you need to go on Dancing with Stars or something because IndyCar racing is not working out for you.
Right.
But
he'd be good at that. I can see him.
So, and then NASCAR on my records, I'm going with Alex Bowman.
Yeah.
I don't see him having a good run today.
So that's a good little segue in. My dark horse for NASCAR is going to be Alex Bowman. I think Alex Bowman today, not really a dark horse, I guess, because he is starting top 10.
Well, he is he runs for Hendrick, so he's on a decent team.
But he needs to get his. He's waiting to get his, and I think today might be that time. A short, smaller track, tempers flare, we'll see.
Who's your dark horse for IndyCar?
You want to help me with the last name?
No, go for it.
Rosenquist.
Felix Rosenquist. Folks,
I think like we talked about earlier with the rookie speed, I think being a rookie does come out to kind of benefit him. The jitters are there, yeah, but as long as he doesn't make that deadening rookie mistake that takes him out of the race, then I think he at least gets a podium.
I see him having a good run. We know, like we discussed earlier, I could see him being there at the end, like you said. I can see him being on the podium at the end of the day.
What about you? What do you got for your dark horses?
Before I say it, Tammy's saying she's going with Kyle Busch to win too. So we got, you know, a couple Kyle Busch out there.
They're betting the
favorite. And the ass says his dark horses are Bowyer and NASCAR and IndyCar Penske. That's the – no, Dan. Penske, the dark horse. Come on, dude.
Now, I like I said, I don't think Penske has the showing they necessarily want today. But I don't think it's anything to go for.
Right.
I don't think you can call them a dark horse.
Though. So my dark horses for the week are going to be IndyCar. I'm going to go with Colton Herta. Like I said earlier, he looked very impressive in qualifying. And I think besides that stupid penalty, but I mean, rules are rules.
Right.
And I can understand it. I think it's kind of stupid, but anyways, I see him having a good, solid run today.
And that's, with Rosenquist, he was right there in the qualifying. So I think it'd be an interesting, that could be the new up and coming looks of the IRL.
Yes, that could be the future of IndyCar.
So right hopefully there. Those two get together and we get to see some of that racing. I think that'd be interesting going on throughout. Definitely two guys you want to keep an eye on.
And then NASCAR, I'm going with my guy again, Matthew DiBenedetto.
You're going to keep throwing a dart at him until he sticks, right?
damn it. My horse is going to win one of these times.
You're going to keep throwing 20s on him.
I'll beat that horse until he gets it up there.
You know, in all honesty, we talked about him. I think he is. This could be his breakout year. I mean, if not, I don't think he's going to have it. So,
right.
It's a good pick. I'm not going to let you pick him next week, though.
All right, I won't. But with that being said, folks, you know what time it is? Time. Uh-oh. Are you ready?
Hey, and a bet is a bet. I will do it. It's not going to be fun. I'm not one for spicy. I don't think these are too spicy overall, but here goes nothing there.
If I can get the damn thing out. There you go, buddy.
Woo!
I'm at it.
You do a Ric Flair. Woo! You get back away from the mic.
Here, I'll get down with
you. Cheers. Holy cow. And with that being said, we are Checkered Records, Black and White Sports, 1.com, BWSports1.com.
Oh, wow.
My mouth is on fire.
Mine too.
Season all. All righty, guys. We are going to hit the button. Thank you very much.
Sean, hit the button.